Hey guys, this is David Kwan here to talk about the future of multi-platform games. This is actually my second video on the topic, and I'm talking about the future of multi-platform games in regards to the consoles PlayStation 4 and Xbox One. And I felt like I had a pretty good handle on this topic, and I did one video, and then I was just like, alright, that's one video made. But then, afterwards, I ended up watching a recent upload by Samuel the Geek. And he uploaded this video sharing his thoughts on E3 2013. I watched that. I'm just like, okay, well, that's an interesting. There are some interesting points that he brought up that I feel like, okay, that kind of changes my perspective on things now. Because a lot of what he says are like, my gut reaction is to be like, no, that's not correct, right? But I still feel like he makes some great points in regards to Xbox One and how friendly it is to publishers, as opposed to PS4. If it actually becomes true that publishers make much more money out of Xbox One as opposed to PS4, then I feel like the future of multi-platform games will be the case where third-party publishers like EA and Activision and Ubisoft and such will start making exclusives for Xbox One and only make games for Xbox One. How likely is that future? I don't think that will happen. I think it's very unlikely. I still think my points that I had in the previous video on this topic, I still think it's more likely that a publisher like EA would make, like for example, Battlefield 4, or let's say Battlefield 5, let's go way into the future, Battlefield 5, right? I still feel like Battlefield 5 would be the way it is on Xbox One, and then when they release it for PS4, it will be without the, without DRM, without the whole use game. Maybe it'll have online passes, maybe you'll have those kinds of DRM measures, but it won't require you to have internet connection 24/7 or once every 24 hours to be able to play the game. And that's something that Xbox One requires from its games. I don't know, would EA actually try to implement that on and take the extra step for that for PS4? I kind of doubt it, because it is an extra step that EA has to make in order to make DRM possible on the PlayStation 4, because that kind of DRM is not set up on the PS4 architecture itself, whereas on the Xbox One, it is part of Xbox One. But Samuel DeGeek does bring up a good point about the fact that, well, you know, if Xbox One is really effective at curbing piracy, at making sure that people don't buy used games and buy games new, and if Xbox One is actually popular among the mainstream public, then what happens is, well, a publisher releases a game for both consoles, and for both consoles, it's going to be more likely that they make much more profits out of the Xbox One version than the PS4 version. So that could be an interesting thing that develops over time. So what could be the future of multi-platform games in regards to PlayStation 4 and Xbox One? What could be possible is that publishers start favoring Xbox One over PlayStation 4. It could happen in many ways. They could start being timed exclusive. They can start having really great exclusive content for the Xbox One version. They could start trying to make its consumers, they can start incentivizing consumers to buy the Xbox One version instead of the PlayStation 4 version, because they would make much more money out of the Xbox One version. This is certainly a possibility that I'm not discounting. It's a possibility that frightens me, that terrifies me, that I don't wish happens as a consumer. But looking at the perspective from the publisher, the big publishers who are only concerned about the bottom line of making as much profit as possible, yeah, I can certainly see this happening. And I don't think it's cool. But then again, I also want to talk about, if this is happening, the backlash of consumers, I think, would still be a factor to consider. The online community is a vocal one, and I know we are a minority. Vocal, rage-induced community of fanboys we're a vocal minority, but we are still an important minority. We're important enough to raise our voices to big corporations like Sony and Microsoft and say, hey, we don't like what you're doing. And that's totally wrong. We still have our voices that we raise, and I think it still matters. I at least think that's part of the reason why Xbox One's policies is that way, and not any worse. I actually think Microsoft had it much worse than what it has actually been officially revealed. And I do feel like, you know, in some ways, Sony backed off on trying this tactic because of our angry voices. I don't know, maybe it's wishful thinking that I think, that I hope that our voices actually matter to these big corporations. I can understand maybe it's not. But I do like to think that our voices matter and that we are consumers. You know, consumers give life to these companies. These companies wouldn't exist if we don't give them money. You know, and if they start doing these policies that hurt us as consumers and only benefit them, backlash could definitely happen. We can start a campaign and protest and all that, and boycott, whatever. I don't know. We need enough people to boycott to make that kind of a difference. But certainly, you know, I don't discount the possibility that the, you know, the future of multi-platform games might side on this side, might favor the side of Xbox One and Microsoft. And, you know, PlayStation 4 might be disadvantaged, and Sony might end up, to follow the bottom line, to follow the profits, they might change their policies to be just like Xbox One. And that, in that case, multi-platform games will, on PlayStation 4 and Xbox One, will be no longer games that we own. We no longer will buy games, we just buy the license to be able to play the games, because that's what it is on Xbox One. And I feel like that could be a possibility, a terrifying possibility, that might happen on PS4. But again, that really depends on how effective Xbox One is and how popular the Xbox One is. All of this really depends on the future of Xbox One itself and how successful it will be. And I made a video about the future of Xbox One, and I really think Xbox One might be pretty successful in America. But in other countries in the world, it might be successful in the United Kingdom. But in other countries in the world, Australia, most of the European countries, Japan, most of Asian countries, I don't think it will be successful at all. I think Microsoft designed Xbox One without the whole entire global market in mind. So, judging that, if Microsoft is really not that successful in the global picture of things, then multi-platform games will be multi-platform games. And I think publishers will be smart to not to alienate the entire user base, simply for being able to enforce DRM on its consumers. Anyway, those are my additional thoughts on this topic. I guess, you know, this topic is an interesting one. There's definitely so many questions to ask, and I'm really glad I got a chance to watch your video, Samuel the Geek, because it made me think about this, and this is my response to that. So I hope you guys enjoyed. If you guys have any comments, any questions, whatever, feel free to leave them in the comment section. I always enjoy a great discussion. Especially in regards to these serious topics such as this. All right, cheers.